Hey guys, and welcome to today's episode of the off-season vlog series. I think this is episode number 13 off the top of my head, but I might be a little bit wrong. It's been a hell of a week, and how much can change in a week, I will try and take you through the whirlwind of it. But first of all, I am now sitting at about 121 kilos, so that's 7 kilos down from the start of the recomp, and I checked in on Sunday. When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot. Not much will change this week. I get my blood work done as of tomorrow. When this video goes out, it'll be today, so I'll have already had it done. Just to see what sort of health's like at the current moment, and if we need to make some adjustments to anabolics or supplementation to bring up those health markers and perhaps reduce anabolics, up supplements or whatever it may be. So we'll find that out tomorrow. But man, this past week, where to start? So some of you may have seen that I trained outside on Thursday.
Decided not to train early doors and instead train at the place Ali's been training. So as you can see, it's in the garden. It's actually a pretty nice day to train outside. But I tell you, I couldn't have done this for the past 4 months. So if you have been training outside, I take my hat off to you. Chris, it's not something I wouldn't be able to do.
And the reason for that is I was up late on the Wednesday. And I'm going to tell you, I got an email on, I think it was Tuesday during the day. And I'll attach the email, a copy of the email here. Now, if you haven't read that, it was an email from some guy called Thomas, who told me he was an executive producer that worked with Christopher Nolan and wanted two actors to go through a personal training transformation in the lead up to a current film. And I'm thinking, this is a load of bollocks, this is a load of shite. So anyway, we arranged a call, he phones me, bang on the dot. This was 6 o'clock on Wednesday night. And the phone call itself was only about sort of maybe 5 minutes, but in that phone call he's saying that he's an executive producer, and the boss is this girl called Deborah Snyder, who works with Zack Snyder. Now I checked these guys out and they produce like DC films like Batman, Superman, Justice League, all that sort of stuff. And on the Wednesday night, he was like, do you have time to speak to her? She'll Skype call you. I went, yeah, I can do it tomorrow. And he went, no, I can speak to her today. So, long story short, I get on call with her. This is 100% true. I get on call with her on the Wednesday night. Now, beforehand, I had said to this Thomas guy, I went, look, I'm an online coach. Is this what you're looking for? And he went, oh, yeah. So I get on the call with this lady called Deborah, and she wants to know what I'm all about. So I give her the whole spiel about, pretty much give her like what I'm about, like VWZ is about as a brand, but from a personal perspective, talk through some sort of client journeys. And she was like, oh, I love it. I love what you're about, blah, blah. Jim Jones, who was our old trainer, has retired and we're looking to throw someone new in the mix. How they'd found out about me was, in that original email, was this Thomas guy's assistant listened to the podcast, right? And they loved it. And this was an episode back in November time, which was crazy. So this Deborah girl says, look, Vaughn, the job would be training two actors remotely in Los Angeles. And it, you know, meaning I would need to go over there. Now, they never said, like, this Thomas guy never said that when I was on the call with him. So straight away, I was like, oh. And she was like, you know, is this something you would consider? She went, if I'd known about you earlier, I would have given you like eight months worth of work training herself for a year. Could you do that? Could you spend a year in LA? And I was like, no, I don't think I could be away from my family. And she's like, could you do 6 months? So the job was 6 months training two actors. I had to put on 20 pounds on the guy and about like 10, 15 pounds on the girl. And I went, I'm going to have to sit and talk to my fiance about this, because I said, I'm an online coach as well. I run a business. Could I do that? And she was like, yeah, you could still run that. You could fly it over, blah, blah, blah. But it would be, you know, other side of the world. And I came off the call and I literally said to Rona, I said, I don't want to do it. And we sat for 2 hours and talked back and forth about pros, cons, benefits, the opportunity, what it could do for the brand, etc., etc. The next day, my head's going 100 miles an hour. So I decided, I went, right, speak to the three guys that I respect the most, and that would be my dad, or Mark Coles and Cal, three guys that had the most amount of influence on myself to date. And I spoke to them all. My old man told me, he says, Vaughan, you've listed more cons than pros. Mark told me at all times you're in the driver's seat. Cal, we chatted through some other options. But when it all boiled down to it, I just didn't want to do it. Number one, it wasn't enough money. I could make more money here. And number two, training a celebrity is not incongruent or not in alignment with where the brand is going. The brand vision, the brand mission, it was a fucking distraction for those 24 hours. And I thought, in 10 years' time, who gives a shit? Who's going to give a shit that I trained a couple of people, perhaps for like Justice League or Batman or whatever it was, and I don't want to do one-on-one. Getting paid X amount of money to go over there to train two people, the way they want you to train, I can't talk about it, can't post about it, and then being away from my fiance in the lead up to getting married, it just didn't make sense. So they wanted me to speak to my fiance at Rona and call them back the Wednesday night. And I said, no, 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 I can't do that. You know, the time difference, blah, blah. I made up an excuse to get off the phone. And then I emailed back on the Friday morning, like first thing, and just declined. And just said, I'd you know, thank you for, I'm very grateful for the position, but it's not something that I can commit to right now. I know I'd be a good fit. And what was going to happen on the Friday was they were going to email me over a Zoom link to go on Zoom call with actors on the Monday. And I knew that, so I just decided to email over and say no. So that was the sort of Wednesday, Thursday. And then, you know, as soon as I made the decision, I'm not doing it, all the stress went away. It was great. I could get back on track with business, back on track with like doing all the daily tasks I needed to do. Saturday, brilliant to see my man Fitch. He did a photo shoot, looked brilliant. And it was just amazing that everything he achieved, he did without the gyms being open. And anyone who said you can't get lean with the gyms being open, Fitch will just look at those photos and shut up, right? Because he got some great images with Tony, TT Image. I can't wait to see them, but it was good just to fucking catch up. But being in an extreme gym, not being able to train, and it being quiet and being no one around was really eerie. So I just can't fucking wait for the gyms to open. Since then, this is now Monday, the physique formula that I have been working on, which is lead magnet, is ready. It's good to go. It's been ready for a while, but the landing page is now done. And what I will do is I will attach that link in the comment section below. There's a 5-part email video series, which will pretty much teach you everything you need to know to achieve the physique that you want to achieve and just really bring, like, level yourself up in every single way. And in it, I talk about training, nutrition, recovery principles, goal setting, and so much more. So please do check that out. All you got to do is just head over to the site, ping in your name, your email, and you'll just start to be emailed immediately thereafter. We are also putting on a webinar. I'll attach the link in the comment section below as well. This Thursday on how to build your glutes. I talked about it last week, but that's actually very popular. So make sure you don't miss out and register for that. But apart from that, I think that's everything. So if you have any questions about, you know, drugs, psycho, plans for next year, you want to know more on the webinar, you want to know more about the physique formula, if you want to know more about fucking, you know, I gave you the shortened version of what happened last week, but if you want to know more reasons why I turned it down, it's just not in alignment with my core values right now and the business and the brand I want to create. And I love my job. I love the clients I work with. And I feel if I was to go do that, that would be work. And what I feel I do now, I don't feel is work. So again, yeah, what a week, right? And it did feel quite empowering for that sort of opportunity to come along. And don't get me wrong, I was so humbly, like, I was grateful for it. It was amazing to be recognised, but it felt very empowering to say no. It really did, and that's just me being real with you guys here on the vlog. I've not really talked about it on Insta as of yet, so you guys are the first to hear about that. You're the first to hear about the physique formula and everything else in between. So I hope you guys are well. Whatever you do, give it the beans.